I know I'm absolutely surrounded by plants right now, but trust me, there's a reason. I wanted to show you guys all of my oldest plants that I've had basically from the start of me collecting houseplants. And these were the first like real houseplants that I got. So yeah, I'm super excited because these have grown so much and I've managed to dig up some pictures from when I first got them or around when I first got them to show you how far they've come. And I haven't been collecting houseplants for a super long time, so these aren't gonna be like, oh, I've had this one for 5 years or anything like that. Like, I think the oldest one is just a year old, but I was hoping it would kind of be some motivation to show you guys that you don't have to have plants for a super long time in order for them to have a bunch of new growth and to just really, I mean, come a lot further than you would expect from houseplants. Okay, so hopping into it, the first houseplant that I ever got was like literally three little cuttings of a golden pothos. And I'll put a picture right here because I took so many photo shoots of my plants back then, but it's actually right here in front of me if I can grab it. But it is now over here, and I know you can't see with all these plants around, but it's got this little vine right here and this one right here. And like I've said in a previous video, this isn't a super full pothos by any means, but I mean, come on. This had less than ideal conditions for it to grow. So it would probably be a lot better, a lot fuller and all that if I had been giving it good conditions. But since it was my first plant, it had a pretty slow start because I didn't know what to do to take care of it. But this one's been chopped up a couple times and has dealt with a couple moves as well. I think it's moved three times, like extensive moves, not just moving from one room to the other. So it's been through a lot. So it's nice that you can still have a plant. And this one's more so to test it, like be a testament against the hardiness of plants that you can have. So this one may not be the fullest plant and not the most impressive growth-wise, but it's been the hardiest and it's taken whatever I've thrown at it. So in terms of that, I think it's been a bit of a champion. The next one is not gonna look like a ton of new growth, but it's rather just to show, I've propagated a lot basically, but it has given me so many more new plants, so that's why it's a great one. Let me just move it out of the way so I can show you. The main plant here is my Scindapsis argeus, whatever, something like that. Or a silver pothos, satin pothos is what I call it actually. Here first is the original picture that I had of when I first got it. I was super excited, obviously, but it is basically the same size. It's not quite as full on top because before it was getting like direct from the top down light, so the top was a lot fuller, but now it's just like trailing a bit more. So it's not like you would look at this and be like, you've had that for a year, but you would think that it would be a lot more full and stuff, and you'd be right, except I have propagated this probably 4 or 5 times and gotten tons of new little plants from it. The smallest one is this one right here. It's just a small little plant, but it's another plant nonetheless. And then I also have this one, which is another small plant, but it used to be a lot smaller. So it's taking off like crazy as well. And then the most recent plant I have from it is actually this one, which is probably the fullest pot that I've put together of it, but it hasn't started trailing quite yet. It might need to be watered actually. So maybe that's why it's not growing very fast, but I've gotten 3 whole new plants from it and I have plenty more cuttings to make a whole nother plant or two. And it just has given me so many new plants that I could have in my space. So although it doesn't look super long or, you know, mature from the main plant, it's given me so many new plants and like so many cuttings that I've put back into the pot. And it's just, it's almost like the gift that keeps on giving. And like I said, the pothos is just about a year old. I think it actually had its first birthday a couple weeks ago. So that's super exciting. The Scindapsis is probably almost a year old. I think in August it will be a year old. So, I mean, both of them I haven't had for a super long time and they've still given me lots of new growth and been super hardy. Oh, and the Scindapsis actually has been through just as much moving and stuff as the pothos. So, I mean, that one is also very hardy for you if you want one of those as well. The next one is probably just about as old as my Scindapsis, but it was on my wish list forever when I first started getting plants. But it is my String of Hearts, of course. And I know you might be seeing that and being like, that's not very long. How could you have had that for nearly a year and it's not very long? But Let me show you real quick. This is what it started out as, which it's super full on top, which is great, but it's hardly trailing. And now, I mean, I've got multiple vines coming down. I haven't counted in a while, but we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We have 9 vines coming down now, which I mean, is much better than the 2 I had originally. And I have this one and I've propagated it who knows how many times. Now I've got this pot of it as well, which has, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 or 12 cuttings in here, which I mean, that's a ton of cuttings to take from that. And obviously if I only have 9 stems in there, that's a couple rounds at least of cuttings. And on top of that, I also have this other pot of propagations from that main plant. And this one also has 12 cuttings in it. So I mean, it gives you so many new plants and so many more plants than you could even want when you first get one. And that is something I think that sums up most of my plants that I got at the start, is I didn't know how many plants I'd be able to get from them because I didn't really think about it in the long term like that. But moving on, I have my neon philodendron here, my partleaf neon, whatever you want to call it. And let me just move some stuff around so I can start showing some more of these plants. But I have this one, and this started out as this little tiny baby cutting that someone gave to me as like a little extra for buying a silver stripe. And now it's a super full plant, and I got this, and then I only recently took cuttings of it in here, and there's just like 2 little cuttings in there. So I mean, not a super like tons of plants from this one plant, but compared to the initial, like what I had, I think that's pretty crazy because it was very, very tiny and now it's going a bit insane and is getting a bit too crazy for this trellis even. And that's one of the newer ones in terms of like my old house plants. It was probably one of the more recent ones that I got right before I made my last move. So this is probably from like, I don't know, like last August or so. Sometime around that, so not super old at all. Actually, it's probably closer to like September. So yeah, last September or so I got this one. So not super old, but still quite a lot of growth. And then one that I just have pictures of, and I did this out of order, I apologize for anybody that bothers, but my Brazil philodendron, it started out like this and I got it in a 4-inch pot and then I moved it up to a 6-inch. And then it didn't really grow very quickly in the 6-inch, so I split it back up into 2 4-inch pots, and then I sold one of those 4-inch pots, and then I kept the other one, so, I mean, this picture, but split that in half, and then that's what I have now, and I don't have it to show you right now because it's behind me tangled up on a pole that I have, so I think I have a picture of it, though, and I'll put it here in front of me if I do have it, but it started to vine around that pole, and I've cut it back several times, and it's another one that's like maintained its good shape and everything with several moves as well. So it's just one that's also been durable, but also been really quickly growing. So yeah, I'm super excited about that. Obviously I always am, but that's an old one that I just couldn't bear to give up. And I just hope that I can always keep it alive because it's been doing so incredibly well from when I first got it. And I almost forgot actually one more plant that I've had for a long time actually, and it's survived all the moves and also dormancy and just all the different environment changes, is my Ficus elastica, and it's a ruby Ficus elastica, which I mean, you guys know since you've seen my videos, but it has been doing so well, and it had a bit of a rough patch when I first moved it, but it has finally started popping off again. And that's one, if you have any ficus trees, you know that they just don't like to be moved. So honestly, with how ficus usually react to changes in environment and that sort, even if you like move it to a different part of the house, this should have realistically lost all of its leaves, if not some, and it literally did not lose a leaf since I moved it. So I'm super happy about that one, and that's one that I can't complain about. And I mean, this was when I first got it, so it used to be a lot more red and that pink kind of color, and it's lost a lot of that, and it's turned a lot of that sort of variegation into like more of a cream kind of pink color, which is a bit of a bummer, but I know that it just needs more light in order to bring that out, and I just can't give that right now. But it's been growing, so I can't really complain. But yes, that is probably one of my favorite ones that I've had for ages. And then last on my list is one that I'm particularly proud of, because when I first got it, it was great and everything, and I mean, that's the reason I bought it. but it was just very sparse, and I'll show you right here. It's my silver striped philodendron. It just was very leggy, sparse, and all that. And now we've got this thing, and it's so pretty. And I mean, it's not an insane amount of growth, but it's just so much prettier than it used to be. And I'm so pleased with it. It's just such a like cute plant, and I'm very glad this is another one, like I said a million times now this video, that survived multiple moves. So it's been hardy, it's been putting out lots of variegation, it's just, yeah, it's been growing fantastically. Some cuttings that I took of it and put like back into the pot haven't been growing phenomenally well, so I think that's just because it's not getting very much lighting, but the other side is growing super well. So we'll fill that out sometime and eventually, but not quite yet. But yeah, those are all my oldest plants that I have right now. Like I said, none of them are super old, but I just hope that this kind of inspires you to go out and get some plants now, because you can have like 5 more of those plants by this time next year. But thank you so much for watching. And if you enjoyed, hit that like button down below, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Take care.